word church is ecclesia in a Greek, which means called out. The Acts church was an amazing people. They were dynamic, they were spiritual, they were sacrificial. And I believe that the modern church today must look towards the Acts church to be our model. So one of the critical features of the Acts church was that they were filled with the Holy Spirit. They were people dependent. They were people who were ministering in the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, Jesus obviously taught the disciples the importance of the Holy Spirit. Jesus said to them, "You've got to wait for the promise of the Father, who is the Holy Spirit. You can only go after the Holy Spirit has come upon you." And now we see a dynamic work of God. On the very same day Peter preached, 3,000 people were saved, and even after that, thousands upon thousands came to know the Lord, and the world was changed as a result of the Holy Spirit working through God's people. You see, we live in a day and age where there is a lot of confusion about the work of the Holy Spirit. They say when you are filled with the Spirit, you speak gibberish. You may roll uncontrollably on the floor, you lose your mind. I just think these things are just excesses that are unbiblical. And then there are some who, in response to such excesses, swing to the other extreme. And they say, we should therefore not talk about the work of the Holy Spirit. There is a biblical center we need to come to a proper understanding of what it means to be filled with the Spirit. And not just to know it, but to actually live it. So you say, I want to be filled with the Spirit. Trust and obey. Don't follow the desires of your flesh, but seek to obey God's will in the Bible in dependence upon the Spirit's help. As you regularly surrender yourself to the Word of God, as you regularly yield yourself to His will, you will see the power of the Spirit in your life.